All right, continue with episode 3. This will be part 2 of that.
Shit. We got one. Walker, sitting in the chair. We got him. We gotta look him over.
Yeah. I don't think this guy came back.
Christ. That light is blinking.
Push it.
Push it?
Why not?
Are you fucking serious?
Here, look.
Fucking lovely. Why'd you let him push it?
It's just the brakes.
Okay, I'll give you that one.
This fucker works?
Seems like it.
I'll be damned. How the hell do we get it moving?
I don't know. Ask Mr. Amtrak over here.
No clue.
We found this in the boxcar back there.
Whoa, is this what it looks like?
I think so.
This hoss will take us right to Savannah. 100 tons of steel. Put 1,000 walkers between us and the ocean, and we don't have to give a shit. I can't believe it.
I wouldn't mind plowing through some walkers.
That's the spirit. Try to get this thing started. There's got to be some sort of manual or something.
I don't know about that.
And if you could keep an eye on the girls and Duck, I'd appreciate it. I'm gonna make sense of these controls.
Don't trust him.
Man, this could be exactly what we need.
A bunch of maps about Georgia's cities. Nothing about the train. Shit, this is it. Instructions on starting the engine. Damn, pages are gone. I can kinda see the indentations from the writing. Nothing about the train. Perfect.
You can read it now?
Yeah, should be able to just follow the steps to get the engine on.
Sounds good.
I forgot it already. I gotta go drop something off anyway.
Here, got some water.
Oh, thank you. He's allergic to bees.
Is that right?
That's all I can keep thinking about. Like, somehow that matters.
It doesn't.
I know. Well, I don't, but you're probably right.
Definitely pry this thing free if I can break it loose first. Doesn't look like the engine has any power.
Down, down, up, up. Up, down, up.
Son of a bitch! Whatever you did, lit the dash up!
So far, so good.
All right.
Now we're talking. Holy shit! We're golden!
Yeah, we are. Golden. Man, feels good.
Let's fucking enjoy this. Mom, let's see if she'll move. It's all yours. Attached. Can you go find out where we're stuck? Get us unstuck?
Yeah.
Really, that pencil is what tied me up every time. Not finding that pencil. They don't give you any kind of direction and help finding it either. Glad I stopped in that RV first.
Kenny, we're loose.
Don't tell them till you're back on the train.
You touch any of my stuff?
I took your water, bro.
Chuck. Charles, if you fancy.
Lee.
That your crew outside?
Yeah.
And the guy up in the cab?
Him too.
I saw you walking through here and thought about scaring the pants off you.
What?
But I couldn't force myself to do it.
You're still kind of freaking me out.
Plain folk will do that. Already met everyone outside. They all warmed to me right quick in direct sunlight.
Chuck.
Yeah, I did.
It's so nice to meet someone normal for a change.
He gave us candy. Ben, too.
Ben is a child. You got candy?
Have candy.
Boy, I got the last piece I got on.
God damn it. Figures.
You met Kenny?
Sure did. Man shares my love of the road.
That's for certain.
I'm awful sorry your son's not feeling good.
I appreciate your concern.
Well, with a little TLC, I'm sure he'll be fit as a fiddle in no time. And I can offer y'all whatever I got, although it ain't much.
Thank you. We'd like to do the same.
Why don't we hold off on that?
Stay with us. We'd like the company.
Candy Chuck gave you. Taste okay?
It was really good.
No funny aftertaste?
No.
Brain's cool, huh?
I guess. Scary, kind of.
Hey, Chuck.
Honey.
Why are you alone?
Why not? Seem to be doing all right.
Fine, then.
I'm sorry. I do like being around y'all, actually. It's nice.
You caught us on a bad day.
You still got a couple of kids. And this one's got a good spirit. That's some kind of something.
You said it, man.
Where are you from? You live around here?
Georgia boy. You saw where I live.
I'll talk to you later.
Hope so.
Keep on strubbing, my hobo friend. Let's get on the road, though.
So that's it? We're cut loose?
Seems that way, yeah.
Great. We don't got much left, so just gather whatever you have. Let's go.
Clem first one up. Sounds about
well,
right.
Sounds like you're taking my home.
That's a yes, then.
Haven't found anything better for keeping the creepy crawlies out than that boxcar.
Duck's sick.
Get on the train, Clementine.
Yo, don't be an asshole.
He's getting sicker.
Let me look at him.
We can't ignore this. Look at the kid, Kenny. This is happening.
Ain't shit happening. And if it were, what can we do here? Get on the train and we find something better. That is the plan.
I think Lee just wants to talk it through.
It's talked through. Get on, Kent. I'll be up front. I don't want to hear any nonsense until we get where we're going.
Chugga chugga choo choo. Get Clem away from Duck, please. Nice forearm, bro.
You gotta be hard on you, eh? Three adults, taking care of three kids. No disrespect, son.
There were more of us.
Dad get them?
No.
Ah, Levin got them.
Lee. Lee, I need you right now. I need you to go get Ken.
What's
up? Would you get that off his face? My hands are full, kid. Thank you. Could you just get that off his face, please? He's out of time. We need to stop this train.
Okay. You need to stop the train.
Get your hands off me!
No! You're gonna listen to me. Your wife and kid need you. I'm gonna make sure you stop this train.
The hell you will! We're getting to the coast, and Duck will pull through.
Stop the goddamn train and come deal with this!
Make me.
Calm down and...
How the fuck do you calm down after a day like today?
By talking to your friend.
What is the goddamn deal? He's a little sick, but we can't just quit. It's a scratch. He's not like the others. Jesus, all y'all are just making it worse.
You're in denial.
And you've given up on Duck, on everyone.
Stop it, goddammit!
Fuck you, Lee.
You're gonna listen.
Or what?
Sometimes, all I think a dude understands is hitting him. Oh, I don't know.
Knock this shit off.
So, you wanna fight then?
I just wanna talk, Ken. Relax.
Then talk.
You think you're the reason Duck was bitten? Like you had this coming or something? You didn't kill Herschel's son.
Yes, I did. And now it's catching up to me.
That's not what went down. You looked out for your kid. And a bad thing happened to someone else's.
There ain't no way this world lets my son live when I help put someone else's in the ground.
That's not the way it works. You know that. Stop the train, man.
And it's... I think it's time.
The boy's been bit, in case you haven't figured that out.
We shouldn't waste time.
There ain't none left to waste.
Rip Duck.
Saying we shouldn't stay put.
What are we gonna do?
Don't deal with it.
We can't allow him to become one of those things.
But what if he doesn't?
Kenny, I love you very much. I love our son more than life itself. I need you to hear me. What you are saying, that he may not turn, is foolish.
But...
No.
There's... Come on, Cap.
If you think of one, you let me know.
Isn't there some sort of pill or something we can just give him?
Stop it.
He can just drift off to sleep. Right, hon? I mean, Jesus, this is our son.
I know. But we know it's here or nothing.
Fuck. Just who, then? You want me to?
You don't have to.
I'll do it.
No, you don't have to.
Got it, boy.
No, it should be apparent.
No parent should have to do something like this.
He's right, Cat. We can say our goodbyes and just let that be it.
I don't know. Lee, you'd be doing this family a great service.
No problem. Y'all would do the same for me.
Into the forest, so Clementine doesn't have to see.
Yeah.
Give us a moment to say goodbye.
Of course.
What's happening?
I gotta put Duck down, sweetheart.
I'm gonna take care of Duck.
I thought he was going to die.
I'm killing him.
For good?
Yes.
For good and forever.
Look, Clem, things are... What the...
No!
Ben, take Clementine into the train. Go, it'll be fine.
You ain't gonna outrun that bullet, man. No way to outrun that bullet.
Get! Gotcha! Why, Cat? Oh, fucking God!
Still have to deal with Duck. Give me the gun, kid. I'll do it.
All right, Kenny, we gotta go.
Talk.
possibly the best scene of the game right here.
Okay. What do you think it's about?
What Chuck said.
What'd Chuck say?
That what happened to Duck would happen to me.
The fuck he did.
Swear.
Sorry.
Shit.
Took some sense into him.
Don't be mad.
Fucking Chuck.
Hey. How you doing?
Perhaps that wasn't quite the scene I was thinking of just
yet. Say it to me, asshole. What you said to my girl.
Excuse me, son?
Telling the little girl she's gonna die. Wanna scare people, scare me. Fucker.
Okie dokie. She's gonna die.
Son of a bitch.
How is that?
How about I throw your sorry ass off this fucking train?
Now we're both scared. I don't know much about you folks, but I can tell you as sure as the sun's gonna come up tomorrow. Y'all keep going on like this, and that girl ain't gonna make it.
What do you know?
I'll tell you, as long as you don't toss me over the rail. I know Deal. That you don't have a goddamn plan. We get to Savannah, and then what?
We find a boat.
You think that's a new idea? You got even the foggiest idea about where you're gonna find one of those. Look, sit down with the girl and hash it out. Find a map, for Christ's sake. I'd give you one if I had it. And if something were to happen to you...
It won't.
If it were, you gotta prepare the girl. Teach her to use a weapon, and for criming, he cut that hair.
You know what, Chuck? He was right.
Like a gun. Are you kidding me?
What, she's too young to handle one? There ain't too young. Not anymore. You gotta consider her a living person. That's it. You're either living or you're not. You ain't little, you ain't a girl, you ain't a boy. You ain't strong or smart. You're alive.
Chuck talking sense.
Find some scissors in my pack and take care of that hair before a walker does it for you. And then show her how to use a gun. Because like it or not, that's what saves your life from here on out.
Chuck talking sense.
Good job. But too many people have died already.
They have.
And seeing another little girl die might just do me in.
I hear you. A plan, a haircut, and a gun. It's good advice.
It's something.
Thank you, my hobo friend.
You betcha.
Next round's on me.
Killed me instead.
Yeah, maybe.
See.
Yeah.
Now we're at the best scene in the game.
I hope we're not on this train much longer. Hey, Clint.
Did you talk to him?
I did. He had some, he explained himself and made some good points. Look, we're not gonna let anything bad happen to you, but there are some precautions we have to take.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
Don't worry, sweetheart.
Okay, what should we do?
Well, we'll figure out a plan for when we get to Savannah. Teach you how to protect yourself and, tidy up a little, so you can't get grabbed so easily.
I'd like that.
Good. What do you think about Chuck?
I don't know.
Me neither. He might be an okay guy, though.
You think?
We'll keep an open mind about it. He's probably had it pretty rough. What a crappy day.
Crappiest.
If 3 months ago I'd known what you'd be seeing, I don't know if I would have taken you with me.
I probably would have run out of food.
You're damn near starved with me.
I'm glad I came with you.
You need to know how to protect yourself.
Like hiding or running away? Got it.
I mean with one of these. First, don't be afraid of it. It's just a thing. Take it. But know where your finger is all the time. And don't put it on the trigger unless you want to hurt somebody.
Okay. Okay.
See? It's not scary.
It's heavy.
You'll get stronger. But aim. You look right down the top, through that notch. Line up the sight at the end with your target.
Is there anything else I should know?
When you're ready to shoot, make sure you're not breathing too hard. And then hold your breath right when you pull the trigger.
Like when I'm swimming?
No, just for a quick second. I found that if I did that, it's a lot more accurate. It's tough, but it'll help.
I can do that. Okay.
Good. Don't lock your elbows. Okay, let's take your first shot. Squeeze the trigger smoothly, and I'll cover your ears.
Adorable.
Nice and easy.
Nice and easy.
You okay?
My hands hurt. I don't like this.
Let's stick with it, okay?
Do I have to?
Yeah, you do. A bit to the right. Okay, a little higher.
I got it!
Excellent. Good shot. Okay, aim a little bit more to the left. Aim a little higher. Aim more to the right. Aim lower. There you go. Nice.
I did it!
Yeah, you did. Good
job. I'm so proud.
I was holding my breath, and the gun didn't shake so much.
See? You did good.
They're not walkers, though.
No, far from it. But you know how these things work now. We'll graduate you to walkers one day.
Okay, I feel good.
Not so scary, huh?
Nuh-uh.
It's a fifth of whiskey.
Right on.
He's lived here a while. They look clean enough. Hey, Clint.
Hi.
So you're probably not gonna like this.
Oh no. What happened?
Nothing. We have to talk about your hair. It's not safe.
That's not nice.
What?
Are you saying it smells?
No.
Because it does. Kinda.
Do you remember when Andy St. John grabbed it, and I got mad?
Yeah.
Well, that could happen again. And if it's a walker, we need to trim it.
Just a trim, right?
I need to cut it short enough so that it can't get grabbed.
Okay.
Mind if we do this now?
I guess not.
Don't mope. It's a good thing.
Hair won't stink if it's gone, kid.
Do you know how to do this?
Not so much.
Nope, no idea. I'm not much of a stylist, you know?
I'm going to look like a boy.
But think how much safer you'll be.
I'd rather be dead.
Shush now.
Clem is
so
great.
So you did kill someone before.
Yeah.
I'm glad you finally told me.
Me too.
You've killed lots of things now. It doesn't even matter.
different.
But you do it now to protect yourself. And to protect me.
I was sent to jail.
Did people ever go to jail when they shouldn't?
All the time. Okay, I think I'm about done. I can probably tear these pieces back with something.
Here, I have some hair thingies.
You do?
Yeah. Lily gave them to me for sleeping.
There. All set.
Does it look dumb?
No. You look cute. And a lot harder to grab. Sorry about your hair. I think it looks cute, though.
My mom isn't going to like it.
I need to look around for a few things that'll make sure we're prepared when we get to Savannah.
That would be good. I hope it's safe there.
Me too.
What's up, Chuck?
Well, the girl can shoot.
Doesn't have to be pretty.
Probably will be before too long. Be safe up here.
You betcha.
I don't want to have a real conversation, but have a drink, buddy.
Damn. I didn't realize I had it left. Thank you. Want a nip?
Never touch the stuff, my friend.
No, I'm fine.
Suit yourself. Anybody in there want to share a drink? You let them know.
I will. I'm sure Kenny needs one.
I was lucky enough to get it working once.
Thanks.
Hey, Ben.
Hey.
See you.
Yeah. It was me.
Huh?
I was the one giving the bandits supplies.
You fucking scumbag. You got Carly killed, you got Duck killed.
It's all my fault.
Just throw him from the fucking train, man.
What for? Why the hell would you do this?
They said they had my friend. That he was with them. By the time I realized they didn't, it was too late. They said they'd kill me. Kill all of us. I'm sorry, Lee.
You should have come to us. I'll never forgive you for that shit.
Hey, Clint.
Hi.
I want to talk about Savannah.
Me too.
And what we're gonna do when we get there. We don't know what to expect. The city could be bad or totally under control. The thing is, you and I, we're a team, you know? And a team needs a plan. Aside from everyone else, when this train stops, you and I should know exactly what we're doing.
A plan. I like it.
Good. I think we should look for your parents.
Really?
Yeah. You need to know if they're okay, and, well, if they're not, what happened to them?
I'm sure they're okay.
Yeah, it's best to stay positive.
That's what Dad always says.
Let's look at the map. If we can figure out where they were, we can start there. Looks like we'll come right through town if there's nothing on the tracks to hold us up. Now we've got a good chunk of Savannah here. What do you think?
They always stay in the same place when they go there. It's,
Hey, don't worry. We'll figure it out. Have you ever been there?
Once.
Well, think about it. There are a lot of hotels on here, but read this map and maybe it'll jog your memory.
They've got really tasty desserts. It's called the, something Mar.
Is this it? The Marsh House?
Yes, that's it!
So we'll head there.
Yes!
You think we have a good plan?
I think it's very good. Can I tell my parents? You know...
Sure. Go ahead.
All right. How do you feel?
Good. Better. I'm glad we have a plan.
And you're a good little chef.
Thanks.
I guess we should see how far...
Oh, shit! Hold on, everybody!
Dun, dun, dun.
That's fucking stupid, Ben. I'm just saying.
I don't know. I ain't got much experience with y'all's fortitude, but we could probably deal with that. We got a goddamn train.
That thing's not full of milk, Charles. That's gas or diesel. Something that's gonna explode.
You gotta get a hold of yourself. This a crew here.
This ain't shit.
This?
Yo, you keep screaming like that and you're gonna get your face chewed off.
You guys gonna be trouble? Because we could've just kept walking.
Define trouble.
Anything that gets you killed, or worse. And it tends to come hand in hand with groups of guys in distress.
Let's get these guys away.
We'll see.
You guys got a problem with your train?
Yeah, you're standing right in front of it.
Dude, it's a wreck. It's not so bad from up here. Send your buddy up to have a look.
Anything goes sideways up there, we won't let them escape.
I forget just how long this section is, so I think I'm gonna wrap that right here. Finish out in the next part. Hopefully, won't be all that short. Next part. In like 15-20 minutes. Alright, well, I'm gonna head out on that one. Until next time, stay groovy.